I can't believe. You never have tasted a Cuban coffee in your life? Okay, there is always a first time. Coffee is a ceremony, a tea ceremony. Yes, very refined experience, of course. We are proud of that. The ceremony of coffee could happen any moment. So the first thing that you offer someone who visits you is a cup of coffee. See a lot of Cuban artists dealing with the ocean. It's a motif.
I was back in the year 2000 in Mérida, Yucatán, Leandro and a couple of other artists. They were very impressed by the rafters crossing the Florida Strait, and they decided to do something about it, to kind of bring to people's awareness the tragic problems that the rafters have.
So you will see paintings in Cuba that all the windows go through the ocean, because this is the big background, and this is our trauma, that we don't, you can escape. You're surrounded by water, and all the street ends in water. So it's like a backdrop of all Cuban tragedy or comedy situations, as you want to see it.
Cuban art is pivotal to the Americas, not just because there are a number of Cubans here, but because Cuba is a place in transition. What is happening in Cuba, what has been happening in Cuba for the last 60 years, is just a moment in history. It's not something unprecedented in the history of Cuba, but it is something that has given Cuban art a particular flavor that it never had before, and that it will never have again after this regime in Cuba comes to an end.
Some people think of Cuba being a Caribbean, just us playing drums and maracas. But the fact is that we have a wonderful tradition, a wonderful art tradition, not only music, but also visual arts and literature. So I think it gives it's a good example of what Cuban artists have been doing for the past 100 years.
The value of Cuban art is exceptional because it describes a number of very complex issues, and it will be with us for many, many years, and it will be unique. The fact that these things are not framed demonstrates that these artists are always on the go. They have to be mobile to survive. And Leandro has done it very tastefully, even in a very modest way, with tacking these things to the wall, writing the description of it on the walls. I think that the energy, the seriousness of the art itself comes through very clearly that way.